Right, so we'll run down this hall and show you Mine Mart. Okay, so JD Naz, one of the players on the server here, JD Naz and I spent quite a bit of time the other night. We were just horsing around, and when I popped over to see what he was doing, he had built these walls. I mean, just giant. It was going to be enormous. So I popped through and convinced him that many hands make light work, and that if we could take these walls he created and finish it. And although we haven't finished it, we have quite a bit done. So this is Mine Mart. And Mine Mart is near JD Naz's place, right over this hill. In that direction is the Temple of Doom, which is AFKable XP farm. Over there is his harbor and his boat, and his house. So we're pretty close to his area. But what he's created is a Walmart, or excuse me, a Mine Mart for players. Okay? So if you want to sell some stuff, you come in, you find your aisle, you put the stuff in the chest, you put your sign on, and he will house your shop, if you will, here in this supermart. And there are categories for pretty much everything. There's brewing materials, tools, hardware. I need to get out here and read them. Transportation and miscellaneous, decorative stone and redstone, building materials, and of course outside, no Mine Mart would be complete without a garden center, which we've done the roof on, but haven't yet built any, what do you call them, raised beds, places where you can put the plants.
What I really love inside is the cash registers and the belts at the cashiers
Right.
areas.
So
I
right
just think
here.
that's incredible. And the lights that go on and off.
Yeah, ma'am, can I take your order? Or can I check you out? Oh, sorry, I'm closed. Here, go to another one. She's open.
I have 50 items, and I know that you're only 10 items or less, but couldn't you just let me get in through this line?
Oh, sure. Come on. No one will mind behind you. No one will mind at all. Okay, so this is Mine Mart. So if you join the server, do come check this out. It's in the hall. I'll show you where we are. It's in the hall, and Jim has done a great job. Just what a great idea. Now we do have a shop district at spawn, and we do have an economy plugin, so you're able to. Sorry, I went for the nether noise to die down. You are able to come and sell your stuff now. As long as we're going to go there, I think we ought to show them your shop.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was pleased with the way that turned out.
So that's Mine Mart. Now let's go and show you the rest of the tour area. So we have the ice spike biome this way, and you'll notice Lyarra, entrepreneur that she is,
Yes.
has put together a place where you can buy packed ice instead of running all the way down there. Or more importantly, instead of running all the way down to her biome, which is also Ice Spike.
Shh, don't
Shh.
tell, don't tell.
No, I know. Okay, so this is the Nether Hub, and we are building out different tunnels as needed. So this one leads to Layar and Ice Spikes, Rimsey's, JD Naz, the Mine Mart, and another Ice Spike. Each of these lead to another location. And then, of course, this is down this hall is Minecraft Grand, JD Naz's place, and Raven Dragon and Lanyu. So, to show you the. Oh, we're going to have to run. Yep. Okay, so we've come out the wrong portal. Where it
I was
picks.
following you.
Yeah, where it pixelated Pyro's portal. So his new portal is now breaking the spawn portal over there. So
Okay.
I may have to fix that. But this gives us a good opportunity to show you the spawn from a elevated view.
I have not seen it from all the way up here, I don't think.
Right. So I'm going to use the arrow to point. And I may
look
set
at
a...
that wonderful snow globe. I wonder who built that.
I wonder who.
And the ice cream cone.
Right? Who could have built that snow globe? If you couldn't guess, it was Lyarra. Wave and take a bow, Lyarra.
Yes.
Take a bow. Take a bow. That's not a bow.
How do I bow?
There you go. There you go. That's a good bow. Okay, so this is Fish and Sticks. This is a shop that sells everything related to fishing. There are a couple of community farms for sugarcane, netherwort, carrots, potatoes, etc. That building way over there is the admin shop. And I have added some new signs. I don't know if you've been in there. Where'd you go?
Not the last day or so.
Yeah, I've added some new signs that we're buying.
Oh, good.
This tall building here, that is the community enchant area. This building right beside it is a shop that Untypical Toast built, and he's currently selling. And I don't think he wants a whole lot for it. So if you're interested in the shop and you don't want to build, there's an option for you.
I think he's only charging 3 diamonds, which to me is really cheap.
Oh, that really is.
Yeah.
So this is a building that someone started. It was just a few walls on the outside. I finished it, and I'm going to be putting my shop in there unless somebody tries to talk me out of it. And then, of course, not to be outdone, Lyarra has built a snow globe, which you're not going to believe when we get closer. And then one thing we did, the ice cream cone is where the Blaze Farm was. And all I did was just kind of wrap the Blaze Farm to give it, you know, a nonconformist fun appearance. Inside there are our central supplies, our potato farm, and the community mine. Since this is a tour video as well. And let me go show you what Lyarra has done. Is this so fun?
I really enjoyed making this.
She has a little snow golem in there. See him running around? He's putting snow on everything. So the name of the shop is Fire and Ice. And if you are a delivery person, you can leave your packages here. Here, I'll give you a jack-o'-lantern. There you go.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. So as you come in, you're being welcomed and you're being told that if you need help, to please ask for assistance from your shopping assistant. And guess who that is? That's Frosty, the sales associate.
And I can see that the chunk has reloaded since I was here last, because Frosty normally is just a plain snowman, which you get by shearing a snow golem.
Right, and this one too, right?
The floor model, yes.
Yeah, yeah, the floor model. I love it. So I'm going to start at the door, go across. So I'm going to capture these signs. If you don't see what you want, ask an associate. Thank you for visiting. Please drink sensibly and drive carefully. Okay, are you sailing L? Because if you are, let me belly up to the bar.
I needed a sign to offset the one on the left.
I know.
That's what I came up with.
Because you're a Virgo. It has to be symmetrical.
Absolutely.
Okay, so we have packed ice, stackable water, melted ice, faux ice, and demon ice. Of course, each one of these signs will tell you, and she's got very reasonable prices. So if you need 16 packed ice for your mob farm, $50 and it's yours. You can make your own snow golem by buying an assembly kit. She has faux snow. And that's wool, right?
Yes, that's right.
Faux snow layer. Frosted glass. Snow golem kit. Snowman adapter kit. I love that. Adapt it. Golems must be re-sheared every time a chunk reloads. And we have been experimenting with a plug-in for DynMap to show the mobs. So we've had a couple of reboots recently, which is what's put the pumpkins back. What am I trying to say?
Yes, that's what it does. It puts the heads back, the pumpkin heads back.
Right.
Do we want to go up into the snow globe?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I so forgot that. I'm sorry. I was just thinking about offering them the opportunity to build, and I wanted to show them the area, which I can do from here. So all of that over there is shop district. So if you want to come and build your own shop, you got lots of room to do that. So this is her little inside the snow globe house with her snowflakes, thank you. And it's a completely livable house, but she will be charging rent if you elect to come live here.
It's a very exclusive area.
It is. And bear in mind, you are constantly on display.
Yes.
So there
but
will be.
But you do have company because the snow golem that's in here lays down ice, which you then, with a shovel, can get snowballs from.
Nice.
And he'll lay down more.
And then throw them at him.
Yes.
Or Lyarra.
That wouldn't be nice.
Oh, sorry. It's what? Sorry. Okay. So let's see that. One more bit. Let's show him the improvements to this Blaze farm. Now we'll tell you, X-Craftability built it, and it's a great farm. And this is how we mend our tools. We come in here to get XP and mend all of our mending tools.
Oh, it's so handy.
It does a great job for that. Let me capture the front here. This is the community Blaze farm. Oh, somebody didn't leave it reset. So when you first come in, let me lower hostile mob sounds.
That must have been me because I was the only one in here.
That's okay. So when you first come in here, if it's not open and they're not dropping down, you may need to press this button. You know what? Maybe we could put that on a timer. Oh, that's another day. So anyway, they build up. You press the crusher. A gate flows over the top to lock out the top ones from flowing into that. The blazes are crushed. You walk up, you hit them. And then you open the gate, and the ones that have accumulated fall back down, and you just repeat the process. So this is a quick way to repair your tools. And if you do want to come and AFK for a little bit to build up your mobs, there is a safe place up there. And of course, your drops are right down here. So,
and it really produces a lot of blaze rods, more than you're ever going to use.
Well, yeah, and at one time, all three chests were full. I think what's happened is players have come in and snagged them.
Yeah, and not AFK.
Right, and that's okay. I mean, it's not okay, but you know, obviously AFK is better. But that just goes to show you just the little bit that she and I do to repair our tools has built all those up.
Yeah.
Now, this is my safe AFK area. You stand right here. You're on top of a hopper. The hopper goes into a chest. So in the event, somehow, a zombie, you left the gate open, or somehow something gets in here to kill you, your stuff will drop into a chest and be safe. And that's just
a great idea. I didn't realize that was the feature there.
Oh, yeah. I just want to make sure that, you know.
Oh, do you have time to show the back of it? Because I think that's just such a cute feature.
Okay. It drips.
It's melting.
It's melting. You know, as long as we're here, one more part of the tour. We have the Skelly farm working again. It's been out of commission for a while.
Oh, and the cow farm. Don't forget the cow farm.
Right. Okay, so you hop down here, and your presence is enough to activate the mob farm. Now, this one is a little more manual. We do have plans to come in and do this, but for the longest time, it wasn't working. And so it's back to working. They'll start dropping in here. You'll crush them and then kill them with one hit, and their stuff will go into that hopper, into that hopper, into that chest. So it's up to you to keep it organized. We don't have any kind of sorting yet. That's coming in the future, but is not here now. So we should see them dropping down. It does take a few moments for it to warm up.
And once it does, it's good. There we go.
Yeah, they come in pretty fast. And this is where I get the bones for my nano farm. I'm building up some bones so that I'll be able to put together all the crops I need.
Bones are so handy for so many different things.
Right? Okay, so can you think of anything else we need to show them?
Cow farm.
Okay. Well, it's been in a couple of tour videos, but we'll just make this a complete tour video.
Okay.
And to be complete, we have to do the slimes.
And have you done the potato farm? That's like the piece de resistance.
It is a big mamma jamma. So on the way over to the cow farm, or on the way over to the potato farm, I'll show you the cows. And again, everything at spawn is considered community. Now, you are expected to, if you're using this stuff, you're expected to breed the cows. There's wheat over there and over there. We harvest it and put it in here. You're expected to do the same. Okay, so you just grab some wheat, come over here, press this up, spam click them till they make a bunch of babies and they're happy little cows. Okay. Press this button to let the water go, and then press this button, and a piston will pull the babies through the block into under there, and under there is lava, and I mean under the lava is a sign. So when they grow up, they will become big cows and hit the lava and die.
The important thing, very important, is to be sure and push the button that makes the babies go under the lava, because if you don't, you build up a large number of adult cows.
Yeah, and
someone who will remain nameless.
Lyarra. Someone was breeding them and not pushing the button, and we had like, I don't know, 200 cows. And we'd come to spawn and be like, why is it so laggy? It was cows. So this is our automated potato farm. There's a villager right there under my cursor. He's hungry. He has no food in his inventory. And there's a villager right there who has a full inventory because he's been harvesting. And he is trying to feed his friend. And every time he throws potatoes at his friend, it gets caught in this water stream, flows across and drops down this hole and goes underground, comes right through here, flows across this, gets collected here until we have enough, and then it fires. They come across here, and this is that piston elevator I was telling you about. Comes across here, this sets the pistons, they drop, they land here, and then they're shot up. Can I see it from here? I don't think I can. Nope, I didn't. They're shot up. They come right across over here. This is a convoluted mess back here. They hit this water stream. They flow this direction, and they're picked up by this hopper. And then they're moved to our hopper chain. And look, we are full almost all the way up.
Almost every time I come to spawn, I try to transfer raw ones into the ovens, the furnaces.
Right.
But as soon as I'm taking a stack out, it's already starting to fill up again.
Oh, I know the feeling.
It just really produces incredibly well.
It does. And we do have chests over here that we try to keep loaded. And it looks like somebody's loading them but not pulling potatoes out so the others are not cooking.
Well, that's because I couldn't use
no more inventory, yeah.
Yeah, and so I figured I would load them up so if somebody came and took baked potatoes but didn't refill it, they just automatically start cooking.
Oh, that's a good idea. Overload them.
Yeah. Yeah,
so I put the baked ones that I pull out in there because I rarely have enough room in my inventory.
I didn't know that.
And there's
show me where.
Okay.
Where do you put the baked
ones?
Well,
in two places. So in this bottom chest.
Oh, the bottom. Okay.
Is all baked. And in fact, the raw ones I've been putting at the top because when we pulled some out, we reached the point that we were backing up into the hopper chains.
Yeah.
Now the other place, let me grab some these remainders right here and we'll put these in the other place. So I do have, remember I told you community resources, I do have that behind that door which leads right here. And then we try to keep this food one full.
I forgot this part. Yes.
Yeah. So, and these are all the resources that have been used and then recontributed as projects were being done. So, you know, if you find something in here, which looks like somebody's been using, and that's fine, You know, there are tools in here that are not needed. You're welcome to them. Everything in here is considered community. So down here, and that wall used to be filled in, down here is the community mine. And it's just a big open area. We, you know, run in some slits. The slits go, I don't know, 1,000 blocks in either direction. So this mine is quite a ways. So if you need something, this is a communal area you can come mining. Now, I don't make the rules in this mine because I don't use this mine, because it would drive me crazy to use the mine that's not being done correctly. Okay, so I don't use...
Define correctly for the folks.
Okay, well, 3 high, torches on the right as you're leaving the main hall. Main hall 3 wide, back hall 2 wide.
No Swiss cheese.
You have to fill your voids. I mine a very particular way. And if you come use my mine, you have to do it my way, or please come use the community mine. That's all I'm going to say. We do have a message board if you want to put notifications about the shop, or if you're looking for something, this is a good place to put it. When you get it, I would appreciate it if you'd come take the sign down. We also do have forums, which you can find at minecraftaddict.com/forums, and this is a good place for you to communicate with us when off game or out of game. So I think that's... Oh no, slimes.
Slimes. Can't forget slimes.
Okay, here's what I'm going to do. It's quite a run over that way. We're going to start running that way, but I'm going to pause the video and then I'll restart it when we get over there. Be right back. Okay, so we've been running for a while. This is actually our second night.
Well, I see him bouncing.
Oh, nice. So we're not even...
I'll get the creeper. You get the slime.
Okay. Yeah, this is great. Teamwork. So
I'll
we're
keep an eye out.
We're just on the edge of the...
another creeper.
Oh, I see that. Ah! And thanks. I had the wrong... equipped. Anyway, so right over here is an area that we had found a witch hut. One of the players has started a witch farm. It's not done. In fact, I don't know that it works entirely. So one of the things we've done is put up a couple of stations and then altered our design. I hear... Oh, right behind you.
Yeah, I'm...
Oh, right behind me.
Yeah, I'm getting it.
Yeah.
Got it.
I've got the wrong tool for the job. Stop. Gah. Okay, forget the bow. Forget the bow. Where is this guy?
Why weren't they spawning like this when I was doing my data tests?
I don't know.
I think more than one player is in an area that the spawn rate maybe increases.
I think it does too. I think you're absolutely right.
Rule one.
Okay, so, yeah, I know. Rule one. Okay, so that's the witch farm. Oh, here comes a spider. Yep, sorry, sir. Oh, man.
Yeah,
you know what? Let's get up here. Hold on. Let's get up here. So, we did a couple of things. And let's show you why. Because you see all these mobs. We haven't lit it up.
Oh, creeper. I need to get out of here before he explodes our
thing. Oh, you have a mob farm happening down there, right?
Yeah.
Here, I'll try to help.
I got him.
Oh,
zombies.
Yeah. Oh, knock me off the...
I am surrounded.
And it knocked me off the... Okay.
How rude.
All I'm going to say is climb.
I will as soon as I get these zombies.
Oh, my God. It's the zombie apocalypse over here.
Where were they when I was doing my data test?
I don't know.
I had to get the darn things to spawn because I wanted to test to make sure that I had my golem protected.
This is crazy.
I'm climbing.
Okay, you let me know when you get up there, and then you can guard my back when I come up.
Yeah. I'm almost there.
Okay,
I'm here.
All right, you're there? Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
This is crazy. Oh. Yeah, feel free to shoot at them because you can't hurt me.
Okay.
You know, no PvP. Do you know what I'm saying? So,
oh, yes, right. So I don't need to be cautious.
No, you don't. Just keep them off me while I climb.
I'm trying.
I can't climb. Oh, my gosh. Oh, that was crazy. And I, so I apologize to all our headphone users for screaming like a little girl. Wow. So I was right up here when a skeleton shot me off and knocked me into the dirt.
How rude.
That is rude. So I just wanted to come up here and show you what we have going on. Wow. Okay. Take a deep breath. So we're collecting mobs down below us. We're going to wait for daylight, and they are going to toast. But we originally had designed them like this, and during our, the initial testing, as Lyarra mentioned, some of the slime balls were falling outside that first interior row. So we went one further out, and initially we were up there. We built it so that we could AFK right there. Well, then we were getting hit, so we built up the glass. Then we were, then he was getting hit, so we built down the glass. So this design works if you're just going to build it in a single-player world and just get up there. You just dirt, you know, nerd pull up and down. But we decided when we added the second one and they were coming in that it might be a good idea to have a central, what do you call it?
AFK.
Yeah, I was thinking the other word, like deer blind, okay, mm-hmm. Where you're just sitting up here. You can shoot mobs for entertainment, but, you know, you're attracting the slimes into your area, and then, of course, the golems are attracting them further. So we do have, I think it's three of these set up, two here, and I think one's right over that way.
We have a reception committee below us, and a small or medium, I can't tell, slime headed towards the farm. Can
Good.
You see him from this corner?
I see one over there. And
there's one.
Let's see.
He's just hit the water under this, and he's headed towards the ladder.
Here, let's get rid of the reception committee.
Okay. Do you see the little slime?
I do. I just killed
you
him.
You shot him.
I did. I did. I killed him dead. Because, you know, that's how we roll. Well, this guy's fast. Oh, this guy can hit me. Not anymore.
It's like we had a creeper explosion over there. And yeah. I don't remember that hole being there before.
No, he exploded right behind you. Did you not see yourself fly forward? I caught it all on video.
No, I didn't.
Yes. You were standing right there when the creeper went up.
Oh. I have armor that has blast protection on it, so I was taking damage from other mobs, so I didn't even notice there's an Enderman down there.
Yeah,
and I know you do not like Enderman.
Yeah, but I didn't shoot at him just for you. I almost did, and then decided not to. Oh, he's down here with a witch, and he does look agitated. Did you look at him?
I don't think so. Did you?
Maybe. Maybe I did. I don't know.
If
here,
he comes
there's a witch. I'm going to kill the witch.
Yeah, kill the witch. If he comes up here, I'll kill him because I've got the looting sword and I like the ender pearls.
Okay.
I don't like them, but Enderman.
Yeah. Well, it could have been a really bad experience I had building an ender farm. I'm just saying. There were a lot of deaths. There was a lot of screaming. Hi! He's here.
Okay. The sun is coming up, so we're going to be safe. And when we go to the ground, when it's safe from the other mobs, we probably could go down now. And I'll go get the Enderman. If you want to keep the other mobs off me?
No. No, I'm going to wrap the video. This is the end of the tour. I'm going to wrap the video. You go ahead. You do whatever you want to do. Here I am.
Okay.
Actually, no. Stay up here with me. You got to sign out. Hit your mark.
All right. I go where I'm told.
Okay, there you go. So look at the camera. And this, ready, set, this is Minecraft Gran. We're signing out this episode of the Let's Play series. We hope you enjoyed it. If you did, smash that like button. It really does help me and the channel out. Until next time, happy mining.
Bye.